Welcome back for the conclusion of Tripod's story. When we left off, Tripod, an injured female Anole, was the target of persecution and bullying by the other Anoles. She was attacked by one of the chain gang females. Then Ziggy began to pursue her. For some reason, the aggressive female calls off the chase, leaving Tripod to face Ziggy. Could the reason for her cruel treatment by the other Anoles be because she looks different? They all appear to sense her weakness and prey on it. Another cruel fact of nature. Being different from all the rest can sometimes spell disaster. Leo, the large male, at least 3 years old, is in his prime. He continues to rule the chain gang, keeping all the rest of them in check. His presence alone is enough to send Simon scurrying to the ladder for cover. As Leo makes his way down, Ziggy quietly slips out of sight. Just how much respect these older, dominant males, like Leo, command. For the younger, sub-adult males, it's a learning experience. You see, Leo's not only their leader, he's their teacher as well. By watching him, they'll have the knowledge to take with them into the future to prove themselves as leaders one day. Tripod has sought cover under a large leaf. She waits to see what Leo's intentions are before moving. She doesn't want to alert him to her presence. Leo is intimidating. But for the most part, he's generally good-natured. After taking a few minutes to warm up, he's now a brilliant green. Leo heads down the boardwalk to take care of some routine business. Scent marking and territorial displays are his main concerns for now. This is done on a regular basis to warn others to stay out of his domain. With Leo here to re-establish the pecking order, Tripod feels safe enough to come out of hiding. Leo didn't even notice her. He soon takes his position on the fence. So thanks to Leo, maybe her day will have a happy ending after all. With Leo nearby, the others aren't likely to bother her. Now she can bask out on the old stump in peace. so. For those of you who thought Anoles were solitary animals with no social structure, think again. For Tripod, life may not get any easier. But for the meantime, despite her injuries, she's holding her own. Her leg may never heal. It could hinder her abilities to hunt and be quick enough to escape predators. Only time will tell. As they say, time also heals all wounds. I'll continue to try and follow this little Anole. It'll certainly be interesting to see just how well an Anole, with a few physical limitations, will be able to fit in and interact with the others. And furthermore, will the rest of the gang learn to accept her? Hopefully, all of these questions will soon be answered. In the end, all I can say is that the future is beginning to look just a bit brighter for Tripod. Things are definitely starting to look up. Because spring has finally arrived. Being female, hopefully, will work to Tripod's advantage. And maybe, just maybe, she too will help contribute to the next generation of Anoles. Here in Anole Alley. Until next time.